Well, I can say that I drive the biggest excavator in Europe.
We actually move per week approximately 250,000 cube of overburden each week, and we're currently producing approximately 15,000 tons of coal. The whole site is due to produce approximately 3.5 million tons of coal over its lifespan of approximately 8 years. The equipment we have on site for removing the overburden consists of an ONK RH200 excavator. It's also backed up by two RH120E excavators and a RH120C excavator. These are supplemented by three back-acting Caterpillar excavators. One's a 385 model, and we have two 365 models.
I've just gradually started off on the smaller ones and worked up to this big one what Banks has bought. And when they bought this, and then I started driving it. I've been driving this for about 7 years now. My job's to take the overburden down to bear all the coal off what we're standing on here, all the heavy rock, the heavy muck shifting for the smaller machines so they can load the coal away. Just feel the power and everything what it's got, the reach, the size of the bucket, the power it's got for digging the rock, and the speed in which it shifts the earth for the rare. It's slower than a smaller machines, but you've got the far bigger bucket, so it shifts a lot more muck than what the smaller machines does. For the larger trucks, the 789s, it takes 4 bucketfuls, and for the 785s, it takes 3 bucketfuls. When you start your shift, you've got to do a pre-check, walk round, just look for anything that might be out the order, anything that looks like it's going to break or it's something that's not right. You can walk inside, there's big doors inside, you can walk right round the engines. It's always regularly serviced, it's just main things is the teeth on the bucket and things like that's changed quite regularly because it wears them down. Odd hydraulic hose pipe, nothing else really. They do a fair bit of repair work on the track pads just because if it's standing digging rock all the time, it puts a lot of pressure onto them. This one's 8-year-old now and it's got 21,000 hours on the clock. The engines was changed after about 4 years, not because, it's just because of the hours of the machine had done, and they got two brand new engines for them. Just because, I think, simply because the waiting list to get two new engines for this takes about 3 or 4 months. So they ordered them, and when they come, when it was parked up in the holidays, they just put them in. So they try to get the jobs done before it actually happens. When the hours is up on certain parts, they replace them so it doesn't get any downtime. It's the best excavator I've drove. I've drove lots of different types of excavators. This is the best one I've drove just because of the power it's got and the speed at which it shifts the rock. Well, I can say that I drive the biggest excavator in Europe.
Bauforum24TV. Construction in Motion.